One of the reasons that we learned a factor is that it does give us a new method for solving certain types of equations. It's based upon something called the zero product property, meaning if we know that A times B is equal to zero, meaning we're multiplying these together and the answer is equal to zero, then either A must equal zero or B must equal zero. So if we take a look at our first example, we have x times the quantity x minus 5 is equal to 0. So we're multiplying two things together and their product is equal to 0. So either the first factor must equal 0 or the second factor must equal 0. And that's enough to know that the solutions must be x equals 0 or x minus 5 must equal 0. Well, this is already solved for x, but for the second equation, we'll have to add 5 to both sides to solve for x. So here we have x equals 5. So our solutions are x equals 0 or x equals 5. Notice how when x equals 0, the first factor is equal to 0, so the product would be 0. And if x equals positive 5, the second factor would be 0, therefore the product is still equal to 0. So for our second example, we have the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity 2x minus 5 equals 0. Since this product is equal to 0, either x plus 4 must equal 0 or 2x minus 5 must equal 0. Again, meaning the first factor must be 0 or the second factor must be 0 if this product is equal to 0. So here we'll subtract 4 on both sides. So we have x equals negative 4, or here we'd have to add 5 to both sides. So we'd have 2x equals 5 and then divide by 2. So we have x equals 5 halves. And these would be the two solutions to our given equation, x equals negative 4 or x equals 5 halves. When x is negative 4, notice how the first factor is 0, and when x is 5 halves, the second factor would be equal to 0, giving us a product of 0. Now most of the time, these equations will not be given to us in factored form. We'll have to factor them ourselves, but once they're factored, this is how we solve the equation.